Hey everyone, Chell here with Prismatic Powders, and today we are going to talk about something that is often misunderstood when applying a top coat, and that is knowing when you should actually be pulling your parts from the oven to apply that next coat. Oftentimes you hear the term flashing or flow out, and other times you will hear the term partial cure, but what is the difference? Flashing refers to the state where the powder has just melted or gelled, and for most powders, depending on the thickness of the part, this only takes a few minutes in the oven for your parts to look uniform and shiny. Partial curing, on the other hand, is when you should actually be pulling your parts for that next coat, because a partially cured powder will allow the individual coats to bond mechanically and chemically. And this helps ensure that you get the strongest possible finish. Also, with many metallic powders, if you don't allow them to reach a partially cured state, the metallic particles, they will shift around underneath that top coat. So you need to give it time to settle and partially cure, or else they won't look right. So here's how you're gonna do it. You need to be checking your part metal temperature with an IR thermometer, because you need to get the part up to temperature for a portion of the time on the cure schedule. If you don't get the timing right, you can risk all sorts of problems ranging from inconsistent looking finishes and even delamination of the coating. So here's a simple ballpark method for evaluating a partial cure. Once your parts have come up to temperature, keep them in the oven for 60 to 70% of the cure schedule. For example, Highland Bronze is 10 minutes at 400 degrees. So you'll want your part in the oven for 6 to 7 minutes at 400 degrees before pulling your parts for that top coat. Now keep in mind, if you have complex part that varies in thickness, different areas are gonna come up to temperature at different times. So you'll have to use good judgment and split the difference on how long you wanna keep it in the oven. Now, if you're doing a solid tone and you're just looking to double coat or something like that, 20 to 30% of the cure time is gonna be just fine before you lay that next layer on. Now, we do have an outlier in our line of powders, which is Superchrome Plus. Superchrome requires a full cure before applying a top coat. That is the way that it is, so don't try to fudge it. And just another note, top coats don't need to be hot flocked for proper bonding. In fact, we typically discourage hot flocking because it's more difficult to monitor your application and make a mistake that you can't undo. Okay, that's it for this one. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more life improvement tips. Thanks for watching.